11 Choice Presents, Commodore 64 Game Code, Lazy Jones.
This is Lazy Jones on Commodore 64, an awesome game I used to play a lot when I was a kid. So let's give it a try. So you're this big-nosed guy walking around in some kind of apartment house, and you go into the rooms to play mini-games. That's quite a big television. Pretty simple games. Same time you have this awesome music going on. All the mini games are really simple. You just have a set number of time and just try to make as much points as you can. Pretty simple, really. I always found it really fun to see what games I get. I think on every gameplay the rooms have been randomized, so you don't know what game is behind what door. There is no bad guys into the game rooms, but outside the game rooms you have three things you have to be careful of. That cleaning cart, a guy in the top floor, and kind of a shadow guy, which was a little bit scary back in the day. In some of the games you get penalized for getting hit, I think. Yes, but in this one, lose time when you get hit. But it's usually 10 points for every hit, and then you just play the game. I doubt I never played all of the mini-games or all of the rooms in one gameplay. Usually got bored before that happens. You have an elevator in the middle, so you can change the floors. Yeah, some of the minigames are a little bit out there. Now what telephones have against grabbing some turkey or chickens? So they don't go to waste. That's how it goes. Strange. But still, so fun. Let's go. How do we go downstairs, please? Sometimes when you come out of the room, the bad guy is straight there. You get killed straight away. But that was not a mini game, just a cleaning closet. Ah, it's the drinking game. Jump over the trunk and get some drinks. I don't know, it was just so cool to have so many mini games inside one game. Even though the games are quite simple and not that exciting as their own. Do a couple more rooms for you before the video becomes too long. Oh, it's a bit different this time. unlimited time, but you can't. Game is over when you hit a wall or obstacle or yourself. The basic worm game. There's the shadow. Jump! Shooting asteroids this time. Oh, nice little collision effect when you hit the meteorite or asteroid. Or meatball, depending what you want. Imagine you're shooting. Shadow guy, ouch! Oh! Sometimes a little bit tricky to get right time to jump over the enemy without getting hit. As you can see. Up! No, I need to go up. Up! No. Up! Jump! Now, up! 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 Now I go up. Do a room or two here. Up, the toilet. Let's see what this game is. Ah, it's a game where you bounce this thing around. And notice you have sound effects while you play, which is good. Quite a few Commodore 64 games had either sound or music, but not both. So there is a little bit of variation between the stages, probably a little bit more than I remembered. Oops! Oops. Sure you can't fit here. Nope. Oh. probably lose some time when you... Oh no, you don't. So you just have to start from the beginning when you crash or hit the wall. One is pretty tricky. So there you go, I think that's good enough. You know how the game plays and how it looks like. That's Lazy Jones on Commodore 64. Thanks for watching.